the little bit that we did for these people changed everybody's energy a lot. And, you know, my motto is, I believe a haircut can really change someone's life. And today we took a stab at that. Hey, hey, I'm Jason Schneidman, the men's groomer, and basically I do dudes' hair. So I started cutting hair when I was 13 years old. I just had a pair of clippers and I was doing all my friends' hair. Early on, all I cared about was surfing and partying. You know, that only worked for so long and then the wheels fell off. So I had to get sober. I asked Chris McMillan, who is a celebrity hairstylist, he's known for Jennifer Aniston's hair, but I asked him for help one day and he was able to take me to rehab and I've been sober ever since. Okay, so we're here at Chris McMillan's salon. You know, I'm here 3 days a week doing haircuts for all kinds of people. And then on my day off, I like to head down to wherever homeless people are and do some haircuts. So I find that doing haircuts for people on the street lifts up people's spirits. And what is most important, I feel, is the human interaction. You know, it's like this day and age, we have very little human interaction. And these guys on the street, they are looked down upon and they're walked by and people are in fear of just talking. So when I start talking to them and interacting, the true person comes out and I can see them for who they are. And a lot of these guys have interesting stories and a lot of the stories are a lot like mine.
Okay, so my name is Graham and I have been on the streets of Santa Monica, California for about 3.5 weeks. Before I was on the streets, I was, immediately before I was on the streets, I was looking after my terminally ill father, but before that I worked as a television editor. You know, you get to the point where you really start considering, should I steal clothes or should I, you know, do something nefarious? And you know, your mind starts going to these places that otherwise wouldn't.
You got a great face and I think it'll help you get that job, you know what I mean?
Yeah. And this is why this has really been a tremendous godsend, because now I can wear some fresh clothes, feel a little bit more like a human being. Because I've noticed that the first week or so that I was homeless, I could go into stores, use the restroom. People wouldn't really bat an eye. But then you start developing oil stains from lying on the street. Your hair gets a little bit matted. And then you start getting the, hello, can we help you, sir, as you walk into the establishments.
Just seeing you and where I came from at 34 having nothing and your situation right now, like, I care for you.
Thank you.
I do.
Thank you.
And I'm here and I want you to be able to succeed. So I wish you the best, brother.
Thank you. Thank you so much. All right,
man. Miracle worker. So today was amazing. We made big change. It was awesome. Everybody helping made a big difference. People brought socks, clothes. There was multiple hairstylists and barbers here doing haircuts, big transformations, lots of talk about work, getting back to work. I did a haircut on this guy, Graham, who's only been on the streets for about 3 weeks. And I took his beard off and shortened his hair, and he looked really presentable and hireable. And he's going to get a job. Let me just say this, okay? In what I've been doing here with these homeless street cuts for the homeless people has kind of snowballed in the social media world. And I got people reaching out to me and saying, this is great what you're doing for people, but most of all, it's great what you're doing for me. And I didn't see that coming. I was just trying to help the person in front of me. So I think, you know, the power of social media, by me helping another person, that's the way that it works. And even more than doing a haircut, if someone's willing to take the hand of somebody that, or myself, that can get them into treatment, that's the ultimate goal, is to do a haircut, to get them a job, to get them back in housing. That's the ultimate goal. I wake up with this burning desire to go out and do more haircuts. And all of a sudden I'm making a post on Instagram saying, hey, we're going out again. And once I tell on myself, then it's on.
the crazy thing is I have been where these homeless people are, and I see a lot of me in them. And, you know, if I can be in the right place at the right time, I could possibly change somebody's life.